My journey through the land of spices was nothing but a constant delight to my taste buds.
Good morning. It's a beautiful November morning, isn't it? I've started my day writing my travel blog on South India. And of course, with my adrak wali chai. Lovely. Spices literally rule this land. Look at all the spices I brought along with me. Oh yeah, the chili. The bay leaves smell wonderful. And the turmeric, sunshine turmeric, or it's also called the haldi. The reference of haldi was made back in 600 BC in the book of herbal remedies. And this triggered my interest in this yellow fellow. I'm off on a trail. Mission turmeric in its various Indian avatars here in our own Pune.
Pune, a city bustling with life, is nestled on the right bank of the Mutha River. The eighth largest metropolis in the country, Pune is situated in the western Indian state of Maharashtra. This land of Shivaji Maharaj became the political center of the Indian subcontinent in the 18th century, when it gained importance as the seat of the Peshwas, the prime ministers of the Maratha Empire. But what sets this lively city apart is not just the royal legacy it carries, but also the rich legacy of food and spices. A melting pot of various cultures and cuisines, Pune is literally India on a plate.
India is known for its chatpata street food, and haldi plays a very important part. Let's see what we find here.
It's very rarely that you find an Indian who is not a foodie. The colors, the flavors, the aromas are all responsible for nurturing the special appreciation that we Hindustanis show towards our food. Like its many cultures, languages and regions, India is a land of many flavors. Every part of India boasts of its own distinct culinary speciality. But there is one common thread that runs through all this food and binds it as pakka desi, spices.
From elaichi in your chai to turmeric in your curries, ghar ka khana is the best.
Namaskar.
Namaskar.
Yes, Sonia.
We Indian love our spices, right from our curries to this mouth-watering fish fry. आज आपण कुठली रेसिपी करतोय इथे?
गोवन पद्धतीचा फिश फ्राय आहे, पारंपरिक पद्धतीचा.
आणि ह्याच्यामध्ये कुठले इन्ग्रेडियंट्स घालतात?
आलं, लसूण, मीठ, कोकम, हळद, धना पावडर, लाल तिखट.
फक्त हळद आणि मिठानेच आपण
मॅरिनेट करायचं आणि 10 मिनिटं ते ठेवून द्यायचे. हे असे सगळीकडे असे लावून घ्यायचे.
या डिशमध्ये हळदीचा काय इम्पॉर्टन्स आहे?
हळद एक तर अँटीसेप्टिक म्हणून काम करतं आणि पोटासाठी चांगलं असतं ते. आणि मसाला एक जो प्रकारचा वास असतो तो निघून जातो हळदीमुळे. हा तयार फिश फ्राय टेस्ट करून बघ.
वाव. I'm going to squeeze some lemon on this. Fantastic. Goan fish fry.
As Sonia leaves this traditional Indian home, I'm sure what's ringing through her mind is an old Indian saying, Annadata Sukhi Bhava, which simply means may the generous giver of food find all the happiness.
Batata vada, basically potato fritters. Who can resist this? Indians love color. They like it bright and beautiful. You can see it from the food that they eat. The beautiful clothes here. There's color everywhere.
From being the life of curries to playing an important role in the cultural and religious aspects of Indian culture, turmeric is also known to possess antiseptic medicinal properties. It is also used in beauty purposes in making face masks and creams.
With a variety of food available here, it is not difficult to hunt down food which has haldi in it. Today I'm going to introduce Manish here and he's going to make some dal tadka for us.
To make dal tadka, mm-hmm. in India you have dal made in two different ways.
Okay.
Either using the normal tur dal,
mm-hmm.
which is boiled with turmeric and mm-hmm. made ready.
Why is it boiled with turmeric?
It is boiled with turmeric because turmeric has some properties which are good to make it non-acidic,
okay.
along with hing,
okay.
and also it gives a good flavor, a mm-hmm. good aroma, and mm-hmm. a nice color to it. We'll start with some cumin.
Mm-hmm. Hmm? It's spluttering nice, huh?
Good. Some turmeric.
There goes the turmeric again.
Yes, it's almost done. Since the quantity is very less and the burner is pretty fast. That is done. You should not let it burn. Reduce the gas and we're going to add the dal. So there's going to be a lot of smoke. Okay. And while it's cooking, we'll just add some salt, mm-hmm. some garam masala for the flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And also what I would tell you is, turmeric is used in different forms.
Okay.
You might have heard that turmeric is available and looks like ginger.
That's right.
Okay, yes. That's the fresh form of turmeric.
Mm-hmm.
It is used in different parts of India in different cuisines which are scattered all over India.
Okay.
And also it's used abroad.
Mm-hmm.
It's used by the Thai to mm-hmm. make the Thai curry.
Okay.
It's a yellow turmeric based curry. It's got mm-hmm. a very pungent flavor to it.
Okay.
But it's very mind-blowing. The Mexicans use it in their salsa
mm-hmm.
and it's even used in many other cuisine.
So is this ready now?
It's almost done. Then I grab some coriander. Sorry.
Dishes cooked in turmeric are always a desi favorite. Now let me taste the dal tadka. That's delicious. I've had a roller coaster day today. I've tasted everything from ghar ka khana to street food. And now it's time to get back to my blog while it's all fresh on my mind.
India, the land of spices.